Now we're going to be selecting the hair we want for our doll. If you are hesitant about a color, I think the best way is to have the color right around her. This is a skin of with a mohair. You can buy them online in pretty much every color that you can imagine. So I have several colors. You can see how the doll and the outfit complement each other with the hair or not. Sometimes we feel very strongly about a color that we just love or we totally hate. I love this color, but I think it is too much for this particular dress color. I also have some orange that looks beautiful. Okay, after checking all the colors, I decided that I'm going to go with the orange red. This one in particular comes in different separate locks. But if you have yarn, it's going to be pretty much the same. If you're going to use something like this, you will start by trimming them with your scissors from the very bottom. As you can see, I have been using this one. You trim your chunks, your little locks, with your scissors. And glue the tips so they are locks, separate locks, like pretty much this other one. And we are going to attach them. I'm going to be picking here which ones I like. I'm not going to put a lot because I still have another little thing that I'm going to add. This one is very, very tight together. Okay. All right. With the camera off, I'm going to be putting them the way I like. And then we're going to proceed to find the little white paper that we have discussed earlier in the videos to make her a crown. Get your fancy trim ready. And we are going to be working on these two things, the hair and the crown. All right. I have my selection of the locks that I'm going to be using, and I glued the end where I'm going to be attaching to the head. I don't need a lot, but the ones I want it to end in a nice curl. We're going to start by trimming the hard edge of the glue, leaving just a very small amount of the stiff part because the glue leaves a very stiff end and you don't really want that. Some do and some don't have it. Like this one didn't need any glue or this other one either. So I just simply left them be like that. I'm going to start by gluing a little curlicue somewhere in there, just shorter than the rest so that you have something peeking from the back. Basically, you just go around putting the way you like different kinds of locks at different heights of the hair, of the head. You don't need to fill up the whole sphere of, well, it's not a sphere, but you know what I mean. You don't need to fill the hair in the back or too much in the front. It's just a little detail. And I'm going to make them in different lengths. The one thing you want to make sure is that it will glue, that is not going to show in the visible parts, and that it is the length that you prefer. So just be careful and you'll have fun. Okay, another one more over here. I don't like her hair even, so I'm going to put one little chunk over here higher. I think I want another of these little curly things in here. So with our material, either packing material, corrugated cardboard, or watercolor paper, or pattern paper, whatever you decide that you like best, make your cut that is long enough to have around her head. This way. So you cut. I don't want to have too much overlapping. So cut to the right length. And with your pencil, mark where you want in the front. And from there, in the back, you will make your zigzag. I think I want them all the same size. Usually I make them all uneven, but for this particular case, I'm going to have them all the same. Before you cut, double check how it is going to end at the edges, so you have a little clue that you have to cut this one over here. And when you glue it, it will be the same kind of going up little triangle. Okay, glue the backs together. Make sure that they are aligned perfectly. Use any glue that you want, but I'm going to just use the same. And get rid of the extra junk from the hair. Okay, it glues really fast. Now we're going to add our little fancy trimming. also. Since my trimming has an up and down shape, I'm going to glue it in a way that is hanging from under the crown, so it is going to help me keep the crown in the head, like little fingers almost. Okay, so cut the thing that you need, the length at the end that you need. Make sure that you glue it in the same part at the end so you don't have too many edges. If it is the kind of pattern that is going to run on you, make sure that you put glue before you glue it so it doesn't run on you. There's also another glue for fabric only. I don't remember the name, but something like Stitch On or something like that, or Liquid Stitch, which helps you with this kind of thing. You just put the little glue at the ends and it will help you keep the shape. We're going to start from the back, adding the glue. Don't put it all over. I like to go in little parts. Press until it's dry. The two wings are ready, and we're going to make a little loop with the wires of the end. We're going to loop them. And twist so you have this little hidden eye over here. Make sure that if there is any poking thing, you either tape it, glue it, or snip it. But basically, we have the little loop. And we're going to hide any other little parts behind the sides over here that we don't like. Anyway, we have our loop and we're going to stitch it in the back. But before we do that, I want to say that with a micron of the tiniest size or a very fine brush, we're going to make her eyebrows, which is a little detail that I didn't do before. So she has her eyebrows, and I selected this very little, very thin ribbon for around her neck. I'm going to also stitch it. You can glue it if you don't like stitching. Just make sure that it's very well attached to the back and to around the neck. Okay, I'm going to be doing that. Because I'm going to be hiding the stitches with another piece of fabric, I don't care about the color of my thread. It can be pretty much any color or something that coordinates with your fabric. But I saved a little part of the crown's little detail, and I'm going to, at the end, stitch it on top. So the wires are covered and everything looks a little, or hopefully totally, neater. Before stitching, check from the front that they are even so you don't end up with something like this or like totally hidden or something weird. So puffy them and make them look even, and then we proceed to stitch. She is almost ready. Now only needs a couple of nice photo shots, and she's going to be a nice looking model.